Hey Tubers, today is the 20th of February. It's about 68 degrees out here, cloudy. Yeah, 20th of February, 68 degrees. So can you guess where I am? That's right, Texas. I don't live in the tundra. We're going to be changing some oil today on the Oliver. And I've already got everything in place. As you can see, there's my bucket down there with my little screen catch. You don't want to drop your nut down in the oil because then it's a pain to find it, and it's a mess too. And I've got my Pennzoil there, my straight 30 weight. Thank you, Phil. Y'all keep that Pennzoil coming. I always got to be straight 30 weight as opposed to gay 30 weight. All right, I'm going to put y'all on the tripod and get this going. Be right back. Now, the oil's coming out. Alright, while that's draining, I'm going to take this filter off. This is a Wix that I'm pulling off of here, and I'm replacing it with a CarQuest. And don't worry about that. CarQuest filters are made by Wix. So, same quality filter. And that shout out goes to the filter fairy, and he knows who he is. So we're going to put this filter on there. The Oliver filter is kind of a weird one. I don't know if you can see that good. It's kind of a weird deal the way it's set up. It's not like traditional filters. But this is a low pressure system, so it doesn't need much of a seal. Let me get this pulled off of here. No, I don't need a wrench. Real men don't use filter wrenches. I've already got the date on my filter, 022010. I need to get a little oil on this ring. It doesn't take much. There's really this, a low pressure system. You're not going to bust this out too easily like you will with, well, the Farmall. My Farmall runs about 60 to 70 pounds of oil pressure all the time. That will bust a few O-rings out, or gaskets, whatever you want to call them. I'm not picky. That's all you need. No filter wrench needed. Mm-hmm. Alright, let me get the camera moved around and I'll let y'all watch me pouring it in, or some of it anyway. I'll be right back in a minute. Okay, we've got the plug put back in the bottom, and now we're going to put new oil in. I like the way this Oliver engine, actually I think it's made by Waukesha, Oliver Waukesha. I like the way they've got it set up for putting the oil in. Got a great big hole. You can get everything in there good. Little bitty holes aren't always the best thing. You spill everything all over the place. When you get a great big hole, you can just slop it all in there. So far, I haven't spilled any. I shouldn't say that, because just as sure as I say it, I'm going to spill some. Okay, I'm going to kill the video right now. I know y'all don't want to watch me pour all of this oil in. I'll be back. Okay, tubers, I got all the oil in there. Actually, I put 5 quarts in, change the filter. I'm going to run the engine for a few minutes, and then I'll check it again after the oil gets all through the motor. Right now, it's at the top side of the safe zone. I'll probably end up adding, 3 or 4 more ounces just because. But it should be good to go. I'm going to go ahead and start it for you. It hadn't been started in a week, so I don't know what to expect. I was just fixing to say the tune-up did it some good. It died. It's never done that before.